And I just pressed go live, which is what I normally press. And it said unable to create stream. So I had a little mild panic there for a few seconds, but it's all good now. I've got my party hat on again because today is my Stampin' Up! Birthday. 13, I'm officially a teenager. Does that mean I'm going to start being moody and answering back? What do we think, Craig? Anyway, I'm officially a Stampin' Up! Teenager. 13 years, 2008, I signed up with Stampin' Up!, so I've got my favourite outfit on at the moment, is my dungarees and my t-shirts, so I thought, I had the dress on last week, I'll go for my favourite birthday, teenager birthday outfit, so I've got my hat on though. I didn't make Craig wear a hat this week. So we're both absolutely shattered this week, aren't we, Craig?
Yeah, I'm doing
it. So, yeah, we don't really know what we're doing, but we're just going to enjoy a nice hour with you, all right? So I'm going to turn the camera around. There we go. Right. Okay. Let's see who's on. Hi, Rebecca. Hiya, Sue. Hi, Paula. Hi, Karen. Hi, Lorraine. Hiya, Sheila. Hiya, Kath. Hi, Maria. Hi, Geraldine. Hiya, Kirsty. Hiya, Donna. Hi, I've said hi, Sue, I think. You didn't miss much, Maria. I just said it was that it wasn't working properly, the stream. So that's maybe why there was a little problem tonight. But I was just saying that it's my 13th Stampin' Up! Birthday. I'm officially a teenager. Hi, Ali and Polo. Hi, Jill. Hi, Wendy. Hi, Stephen. Oh, Stephen. I was just going to say that is dedication. What a guy. I hope ladies read Stephen's comment. Lisa's out on a works do.
Wow.
But Stephen's at home watching and listening on the big TV. You deserve a shout out, Stephen. That's kudos to you. I know that Sally's out as well, but I bet Gary's not watching. Sally sent her apologies earlier on. No, that's brilliant. We're very impressed, Stephen, and I'm sure Lisa will be too. So how hiya, Sandra. Wowza, Geraldine, I know. So tonight, honestly, last week I had a sort of clear idea what I was going to make. I had to make something nice, you know. This week I've brought home 7 stamp sets from my office. I have not been in there today. I've worked from home today. And I thought, right, okay. So I am going to try and do a mail-themed card tonight, just in case anybody's not quite organised for Father's Day on Saturday, Sunday even. So I've brought some papers home to do some cards. Hi, Val. I've brought some papers home to try and do some cards with just with some papers, doing, you know, using some scraps up. I've got my blends out. I've got, as I say, I've got 7 stamp sets. Might do some colouring. I've got some black and white papers as well, which are always pretty good for mail themed cards. So yeah, just gonna see how it goes tonight. So I have brought home the bit of Ronin there to start with, eh? I've brought home some of the 6x6 papers. Oh, I've just realised I've not brought home one that I really wanted. Isn't that typical? Nice bit of Ronin there from this one. Hi, Janice. But I've got a backup plan if I don't have that. So let me find a piece of card that I need. Hopefully, if I haven't got the paper that I wanted, I've got the card and I have. So that's all good. Oh, I've only got one sheet though. Right, so what I'm going to do, because I've not got papers, I'm going to do some embossing. So let's cut this in half. The ideas are flowing now in my head. So I don't know if you saw my Facebook live. Oh, hi Anne. Oh, thank you Anne. Don't know if you saw my Facebook live from Tuesday. It's on here. But I did a cricket themed card. So for anyone who's got cricket fans in the family or friends, then a few ideas for you there. Using just some card and inking some card and cutting it down. Okay, let's make a card blank too. Okay, just made two card bases there, and what I'm going to do is these are a set of embossing folders. They come as a two pack, and they're always right at the back of the catalogue, and I think people forget about embossing folders. And hang on, where are they? They're here, checks and dots, okay? So very useful. You get two for £7.50. So they're perfect for putting through the little machine, the mini machine, yeah? Oh, now I have to read this because I don't often do embossing and I have to work out what I'm using. Okay, so these are, that's just for dies. Insert embossing folder. I think it's the light one because it's a thin folder. So I'm gonna do both of them. And hope it works. Use with standard. Oh, this is a standard. I'm using the wrong one. Oh, you only need one. I'm not, you know, it'd help if I looked at the actual pictures. Hi, Elaine. I'm just battling with this and I'm not looking at the pictures properly. Oh, there we go. Look, it's going through like a dream now. There we go. A little bit of... Oh, that hasn't worked. A little bit of Jersey Boys there for you. Number one and number three, right, that's why. Right, you need number one and number three, guys. Oh, here we go. It actually works if you read the instructions. What a revelation. I told you I'm tired. Look at that, nice checks. Oh, that's so crisp. Really cool. So we'll have a few spots as well. Now I know what I'm doing. So you don't need the clear place. That's okay. So look, it tells you here, use number one, which is the white one, and then you put your embossing folder in, and then you use number three on the top, which is the light grey one. So the white one and the light grey one. It goes through like a dream when you do it properly. There we go. I love this folder. Oh, look at that. That is amazing. They're really... I can't stress how great embossing folders are. Because once you've got them, you can create all sorts of... textures and stuff. Yeah. Right, so what I'm going to do is what I always do when I'm stuck for an idea, is I go back to an old design, yeah? Back to an old design. So, my old design is my patchwork one, yeah? I like doing my patchwork cards. And I cut them at 3 centimetres. Not actually done a patchwork card for a guy's before, so this is new. So at least it's not like I'm rolling out old. Please do a thumbs up if you can, that would be amazing. So these are 3 centimetres, but you do need 12 of them. These are the bright, so this is Poppy Parade, this one that I'm using. Okay. We're all quiet tonight. Right, has anybody guessed what I'm doing yet? With the colours that I'm using. I've used red. And it's quite appropriate at the moment, let's just say. Michael's sticking his thumbs up, bless him. It was lovely that, wasn't it, Mal? I'm not doing an England flag, but yeah, I'm trying to. I thought I'd do an England themed card. I love this song. I've not got a football stamp, but yeah, I'm doing a sort of red, white, and blue type. Thought I'd do a red, white, and blue type card. So that's a new thing. Looks a bit like Lego because of the embossed. Slip away. Is that the one where you? Sorry, Craig. Is that the one where you put it on Twitter and the actual guy liked it, didn't he? Is it Andrew something? I think. I bet you like that one, Val. It's a right Val one, that one. Thank you. card like this is I line it all up first, okay? And I've got four different designs and three of each. So it's really, I try not to have the same design on any of the rows, the columns or the rows, yeah? That makes sense. Ah, you love this, Rebecca. I was thinking, oh, Rebecca will like this. Geraldine, these are your faves to do with all the lining up. So yeah, feeling a little bit nostalgic today as it's my 13th year with Stampin' Up and thinking about all the people I've met and the places I've gone to. That sounds like a Dr. Seuss book. Or the places you'll go, I think it's called. And places that I've only been to because of Stampin' Up. So I'm feeling very grateful today. And a little bit nostalgic. Oh, did it? Yeah, I'll tell Craig to read that, yeah. Have you seen it? It got that one especially for him, Rebecca. And he's got me to blame for your craft room. Does he still call me Julie Cards? Is it Julie Cards or Julie Japes? One lady's husband calls me Julie Cards. The lady at the post office does as well. Have you seen Rebecca's comment, Craig? Have you seen a second comment? You'd love to wear it again. Okay, so we've got our red, white and blue. It's a little bit full on. It looks like Lego, I think. Right. What I'm going to do, I think I might actually... What am I going to team with it? Which stamp set? I actually think... I'm going to use this one with it. Some ties. Not used this for a while since our coffee and card. Back in, this was the one that was forever delayed. Oh, you blame me. Oh gosh, I'm getting the blame. But Stephen, does it make her happy? Happy wife, happy life. I'll colour in with some blends. That's good, isn't it, Rebecca? I'm going to colour in with some blends. A bit of every time we touch. Who's that by? Oh, I thought it was. I'm going to have to use the thin end because I'm losing control with that end. So I'm just going to go around the edge. Just not in any particular neatness. So it's a little bit faded in the middle. I think everybody's tired this week. Everyone who I'm talking to is really tired. Oh, you're in your caravan, Kirsty. Oh, lovely. It's a bit like that here, Val. Whereabouts are you, Kirsty? Oh, that's lovely. I'm sure Craig will do that because he always tries to play that song. Ali's left you a lovely comment. Is that all right, love? Colouring them all in. I'm in a colouring mood. Oh, Anglesey, lovely. Oh, wow, Paula. I'm going for my second vaccine tomorrow. Brought it forward. It's come forward. I've brought it forward 4 weeks. Thank you. Right, let's cut these out. We do have dies, of course, that match these, but I'm not adverse to cutting a tie or two out. Are going to actually go with this card I've done, so we'll do them on another card. Right, I've got four ties. not four candles. Just doing a few of these. Yeah, steaming is funny. Craig likes that too, I think. Like stuff like that. Especially for Ali tonight, Wendy and her dad. That was lovely. There you go, Ali. That was lovely. Right. Do you like Four Candles sketch, Craig?
Yeah.
Yeah. Stephen, I think you and Craig would get on. I think you'd like similar humour. That's a bit skimmy. Oh, never mind. I told you we're tired today. I'm going to use some ribbon that is retired. That he's come up to tell you that, Rebecca. So this is from the new Cinderella. I don't know what's going to happen now with that. It was due to open before the 19th of July, so I don't know. That that is a bit skew if I might have to redo that sentiment, but I'm just going to stick that little bow tie on there like that and do a cutesy little Father's Day card, but you get the idea. But I think I will redo that one and stamp it a bit nicer. Yeah, I've had an idea for another one. Right, let's colour these in. What time are we on? Maybe just get a chance to do this one more card. Lisa's home. Well, Lisa, if you're logging on, Stephen's been holding the fort. She's here and he's done a sterling job. We're all dead impressed he's tuned in. In fact, maybe Stephen should have a song choice. Some of you have this stamp set from the coffee and card. Lisa, you've got this, Lorraine's got it. Okay, we'll cut these out. Queue there. I love that song. It's been a while since you've done that one, Craig. Lovely. Lovely. Wow, it's 8:10 already. So when I'm cutting, I always leave a little bit of white edge. Like that. Right, that didn't take long. So I'm going to use these black and white papers, I think. These are from the papers that are at the back of the catalogue that you get with stamping rewards. I've used them in the puffing card class, which is actually on Saturday. If you want to watch along, the videos are already there and uploaded. First one goes live at 2, and then 2:45, and then 3:30. So do tune in if you can. I actually might use a different stamp. I'm just looking at Sue loves Phantom as well. Right, okay, so the trick with this is I don't want to have that thingy edge, yeah? So I'm trying to remember how to do this now. sort of done it, but it's not brilliant. I've tried to cut it down. Phantom medley there. Oh, friction of me too. Years and years since. Yeah, but you like Love Never Dies, don't you, Craig?
Mm-hmm.
Have you seen that, Stephen and Sue? Have you seen the one that was on YouTube? Was it on? Missed the first 5 minutes and missed the top song. Curl these to get a little bit of extra depth. What's great about the check papers is you can use the checks to sort of count if you've got it spaced out right. And I think I'll lay that flat. So I'll reapply some more glue because that will have dried off. Val and Rebecca getting the two Ronnies and the Markham and Wires mixed up. Bless you both. Right, that's. I'm just going to fold that down. Okay, and then inside. Where's that big stamp gone? This is the one I got a bit skew with last time, so let's try and get it. Oh, it wasn't his last day, Wendy, but thank you. He had to take his stuff in and he took his presents in for his teachers. He has got supposed to be having an assembly soon. But I'm not sure what's going to happen with that because it was after the 21st of June. And I don't know if I'll be able to have a gathering of so many inside the school, so I don't know. So, yeah. So, there we go. It's only a simple one. But it'll probably be used on Sunday. I've made my dad's card, actually. I don't know if you saw that one. Got that one, and we've got this one that's going to get redone. Lovely, lovely Les Mis. Been a while, the Les Mis, Craig. Lovely bit of Les Mis, and that might look quite nice actually. Anyway, I'm going to do. Let's do another tag. Let's finish this card for the England guys. Yeah. You know, whether you're a football fan or not, we have to get behind. We have to get behind the country, that's what I say. Two full cards. Last week I did that huge card and this week I've made two tiny cards. In fact, I'm thinking, I actually think I'd quite like this one. And I can do the other one inside. Val, that's funny. We have to be optimistic, Val. they won the first game, Val. They've not won for ages. The first game. I was listening. Tomorrow night, anyway, the big game. England v Scotland.
Scotland.
Ah.
You like Bash,
yeah? No, but only for today.
Yeah. Awesome.
Tomorrow, Scotland. Eh. What time are we on? Oh, we're nearly at 1:30. I'll just finish this card so we can be finishing off now. Oh, I've not felt on form tonight. Made countless mistakes, but I am human. I think it needs maybe something else on, but another bow tie up there maybe, but I think I peaked with my cricket card on Tuesday. Let's do it. Quickly do another one. Oh, I've just had an idea. Probably won't work because I've embossed it. But that turned out better than I thought. To do my fair share of cricket cards over the years, if I'm honest. Oh, thanks, Paula. I don't feel like it was my finest moment this evening, but Dickie Bird. Oh, he's an umpire. What do you mean, Richard Beno? He was a commentator. He had a very distinctive voice. I thought I was colouring in time to the music earlier, Ali. I was really aware of it. Okay, I've just in the nick of time finished that second card as Craig finished there. So let's move all the mess out of the way. Two cards, woo! So actually that one's actually turned out a little bit better than I thought in the end. Right, there we go. There are tonight's cards. just try and move a bit of the debris out of the way. Just shove it all out of the way gently. Okay, so brought home 7 stamp sets and only ended up using 2. If you're wondering which one I used for the It's Your Day, Enjoy It, it's actually from the Happiest of Birthdays, but it doesn't say anything about it. It's Your Day could mean Father's Day as well. So yeah. And oh, thank you, Elaine, that's really kind of you. So I thought I'd do the red, white and blue for sort of like the England thing. So on Saturday I have my puffin paper party. Try saying that fast. Puffin paper party. And there's 3 cards. One of them, the middle one, is a fancy fold, and it's a really lovely fold that I've discovered. So, oh, thanks, Stephen. Really, really, truly. I know we've been joking, but thank you for watching. That is dedication. Really, really lovely that. Thank you. So that's on Saturday afternoon at 2. It's pre-recorded, but I will be there to chat on the chat like you are now. And next Tuesday it's coffee and card round 12, week 3. If you're wanting to book onto the Peaches coffee and card, then please do so in the next week or so, because I need to get those booked. I need to get those ordered. Thank you to the ladies who've already ordered. But yeah, if you want to book onto the Peaches, that would be grand. And yeah, beautiful evening, sunshine, music and craft. It's a bit overcast here, so Wendy, so it was gonna rain today, but it didn't really. It's been a bit dark though tonight, but we've not had to put the light on. It's still quite bright on the camera what I can see. Oh, thanks Ali, thank you for watching on ahead of watching on Saturday. So thanks for a lovely evening. Oh, you had some rain there, Sue, over in Farsley. Oh wow, so we'll say good night to you. Hang on. So thank you for sharing my teenage birthday with me. There we go. Oops, turn the camera around. There we go. Can you negotiate all the stuff, Craig? There's not as much as usual. So thanks for tuning in.
Thank you much.
Thanks for tuning in tonight. As always, thanks for your lovely comments. How good was Stephen watching?
Fantastic, that.
Stephen, that's like brownie points for Stephen.
Listener
there,
of the week,
Lisa.
I think.
What's that?
Listener of the week.
Listener of the week,
definitely.
Yeah. Listener of the week. So thanks for tuning in. We will see you next week for week 54.
Indeed.
And hopefully we'll be a little less tired. But Craig, to say you were tired, you've done some cracking tunes there tonight.
Cracking cards there as well.
I've done England colours. I thought I'd go for England. Anyway, we will see you next Thursday. I'll probably see you on Saturday and Tuesday. So see you later. Bye-bye.